let's look at how to do descriptive statistics in Excel. It's pretty straightforward once you know where to go and what to do. First, before we actually do the descriptive statistics, we need to make sure that we have the add-ins enabled. To do that, you'll go to File, scroll down to your options. When this comes up, go to Add-ins. And here you'll see I have three active application add-ins, the Analysis Toolpak, the Analysis Toolpak VBA, and the Solver add-in. We're going to go ahead and turn on all three of those. Go down here to Manage, Excel add-ins, go, and then make sure they're checked here. Once they're checked, click OK, and it's going to take you right back to your data. Now, in order to find these and use them, you'll go to the Data tab. I'm actually already on it, and they're going to be over here in this Analyze section. You have Data Analysis and Solver Pack 4. Now that we have those add-ins enabled, let's go ahead and get into the descriptive statistics. Here I have multiple different pieces of data. I have the average price per avocado, the total sales volume, volume by the different varieties, volume by total bags sold, small, large, and extra large. Let's keep it simple and just look at the total volume sold per week. First, go over to Data Analysis. Click on this. It's going to bring up a variety of different analyses that you can do. Today, we're looking at descriptive statistics, so I'm going to select that and click OK. Now I have a pop-up. I've done this once before, so it's pre-filled. Most of the time, this is going to come up blank. Select your input range. In this case, we want to look at the total volume of avocado sales, so I'm going to select column C. Since I have a label in the first row, I'm going to go ahead and check that box. Now, my output range, where do I want to put this information? I've got some space on this spreadsheet, so I'm just going to put it a little bit spaced out to the right. And I'm going to select summary statistics and confidence level of 95% for the mean. Once you've checked those, go ahead and click OK. Now your data is going to come up. I'm just going to fit these columns and go ahead and label it. Within this, now you can see all your different descriptive statistics that you've requested, from the mean to the standard error and a lot of other details about your data. You'll notice here that I have a bit of an error on mode. In this data set, I don't have a value that occurs more than one time in the data because there is variability week to week on the sales, even if it's just by a few avocados. So don't be surprised if you occasionally get some errors here. It doesn't mean that there's something wrong with your data set. It just means that there may not be the information available to create that statistic. Creating descriptive statistics is as simple as that. Have any questions? Let me know in the comments.